In this video, we are going to see how the sessions are conducted in PHP. So sessions, just like cookies, sessions are used for remembering the user details. So the difference, main difference between the cookies and sessions are, cookies are stored in the client side, whereas session variables are stored in the server side. So what happens as a result, sessions are more secure. As it is stored in server side, they are more secure than the cookies. That is, no information is being sent back and forth between the client and the server. And sessions work even when the user has disabled cookies. Even the when the user disabled cookies, still the session variables and their values work. So cookies, on the other hand, can be used to track information even from one session to another session by setting its time parameter. So these are the main difference between a session and a client. But both will store the information of user. So for example, username, his preference, his password, everything will be stored as either as cookies or session. If it is cookies, it will be stored in the client side itself. If it is a session, it will be stored in the server side. Both will help in tracking the website. So for example, when the user log in to the home page of a particular website, when he moves from one page to another page, he'll be logged in. So he will be tracked throughout the pages, on all the pages of the website. They need not to, when they move from one page to another page of the same website, they need not to log in and again and again. They will be identified with their credentials. That is the main thing with both cookies and session. So a session, it creates a file in a temporary directory on the server side where register session variables and their values are stored. So the session variables and their values are stored in the server side in a temporary folder. This data will be available to all the pages of the website when during the visit of the particular user. The location of the temporary file is determined by setting the php.ini file called session.savepath. So it is a configuration file where you can set your path. That is where you can find your session variables that can be set. So we have to give the path in this. When a session is started, following things happen. So what are all the things happen? First, in the a unique identifier will be created for a particular session and that will be stored in the temporary folder. So PHP first creates a unique identifier for the particular session, which is a random string, which is of 32 hexadecimal numbers like this. It will be like this. See here. So then a cookie called PHP sesh ID is automatically, it will be sent to the user computer with where this value is stored. Storing the this unique session identification string. A file is automatically created on the server in the designated temporary directory and bears the name of the unique identifier prefixed by this. That is the same ID. So when a PHP script wants to retrieve the value from a session variable, it automatically gets the unique session identifier from this cookie, PHP sesh ID, and then looks, it get it from the client side and match the data with the server side value. So where it is stored in the temporary directory, just now we have seen. And it compares and it allows the user to proceed. So a session ends. When a session ends, when the browser is closed, or when the user logged out, or when the user don't do anything at least for 30 minutes. So a minimum time will be given. It depends upon the websites. Some websites give only 5 minutes. If the user is not active, then automatically he will be removed from the session. So if he want to further process, he has to log in. So it depends upon the website. But normally, maximum time allowed is 30 minutes duration. So till that, there is no need for him to be active. But after that, he has to log in again. So starting a PHP session. A PHP session is easily started by making a call to session like this. Session underscore start. This is the syntax. This function first check if a session is already started, and if none, then it is started. it is recommended to put the call to session set as the first line at the beginning of the page. Now, session variables are stored in an associative array called $_session. So this will be stored as an associative array. We'll be seeing in we'll be going through this also in a short. So a session can be started with the function like this. So studio data in the session. Now we'll see a small program. The name we have given is php session start.php. Here first line will be the session start. Then using the session variable, we declare the then using this global variable $_session, we declare the variables for this session. As this given, then value is allocated for this. Then we have written a small HTML code where there is a reference, hreference, there is a hyperlink is given. So in order to read this data, first this will be read. Session start, during the session start, these values are allocated. In order to read this value, you have to press this hyperlink so that it will be redirected to this program, php session 2.py, where these values will be read and displayed on the screen. So what is that? So when you run this coding, it will be like this. To read your username and password, click here. When you press this, this file will be executed. So php session 2.php, which is nothing but again, we start that session. And then if is set, why is set? We are checking whether the value is, some value is in that particular session variable or not. So for in order to do that, we have to check. You can use is set function. So is set $session username and is set $session password. This is what we have used. These are the variables. So if it is set, then we print the value. That is echo, welcome, all these things are done. See here like this. Welcome Radha, the username is printed, and then your password is, then we print the password also. Now we'll see the execution part of this. First we have to do session start. Okay, then these are the lines, the same lines, and then session, the next one, session start and php session start and php session 2. I just execute. Yes. Now this program is executing. Here in the first two lines we have allocated values, some values for the session variables, and the session has started. Now we click here. If you see, it will call the php session 2 and the data which I have placed on the session variables are printed. So the next one, this is a very small example for session. Now we are going to see, so that the data in one web page is, we are able to access it in another page. That's what we have seen now. Now we'll see, there are many times you have seen, you are the 300th visitor, 500th visitor, like that. If that, how many visitors have visited that website, all those informations you must have seen in some websites. Like that, you can make a counter to be of static variable and you can keep track how many times a particular website is visited. So we are going to see that now. So if you take this example, first start the session and then you check for the counter variable. And it is a, that is a session variable. So session variable, it keeps track of how many times a particular website is visited. So here, if it is already visited, say for example, fifth time, then it will count 6. Counter equal to, so this can be written like this. Counter equal to counter plus 1 can be written like this. Plus equal to. So it will give the same answer, same result. That is $_session counter equal to $_session counter plus 1. Instead of that, you can, in short form, you can write like this. Then else, if it is not a, if the website is first time visiting, then this statement will be executed. That is, initialize, counter equal to 1. After that, this will be taking place. Then you have visited the space, this page, and then we print the variable value in the session. Now, from the HTML file is formed, where we print the value, that is this echo, this message we are printing. Now we are going to execute this program. We'll see how it works. PHP, this session call. This is a session call. Just let me execute this program. See, already I have visited this page, so it's coming. Now I just refresh this and execute it. See here, it gets say that I'm visiting it for 16th time. Okay, so it is used to count how many times a particular visitor has. It is still remembering the previous count. That's why it is displaying. Even if I opened a new browser and shows, it says that coming. Suppose I'm closing everything here. Now I close the browser and try to execute again. See, already one is initialized. Now you have visited this page for 2 times again. So when you close the browser, automatically session variables get destroyed. How to destroy a PHP session? You can use session destroy, or you can session destroy. What it will happen if you have destroyed some 5 or 6 session variables or more than that, everything will be destroyed if you use session destroy. If I want to remove only one session variable, then better you go for unset function. See, like this, unset, then you have to give the session variable. This will remove only this username, whereas this will remove everything. All the session variables will get destroyed by executing this line.